It's Sway in the Morning.
Only on Shade 45.
And now we have someone that, man, wow, that I really admire. Bob Gruen is here, ladies and gentlemen. You have a new book, Rock Scene, Bob Gruen, right?
And, yep, well, thank you.
And you know, with you, you know, I'm a big fan of music culture, you know what I mean? And not just what's happening today, what's happened in the past to get us to today. And just to put it in perspective, you've been a photographer for about, what, 40 years?
Yeah, since the late 60s.
Late 60s.
I think my first photo pass was 1965, actually, for the Bob Dylan at the Newport Folk Festival.
Bob Dylan.
When
wow.
he played electric and kind of announced that rock and roll was the folk music of America.
And you were there?
Yeah.
Wow. And what was Bob,
exciting.
What was he like then?
He was the young rebel, you know, the spokesman of the generation at the time.
Mm-hmm. What was the paparazzi scene like at that time? Was it as aggressive as it is now?
Not at all. Not at all. It's really grown a lot nowadays. Back then, you had to actually know how to operate a camera to take a picture. Nowadays, the camera operates itself, so it's a lot easier for people to get out there and take pictures.
What do you think of the new technology, like these digital cameras, where, you know, like that you learned, like from age of 4 or 5, you were developing film using three different solutions, right?
Right.
Yeah. Okay. I did
it's
this.
Pretty complicated, and it's actually get very messy with all the developers and fixtures and stuff. Mm-hmm. I actually like digital. It's a lot cleaner. It's a lot easier. A lot quicker. You find out right away whether or not the picture came out or not.
And, okay.
And the old days, you had to wait a day or two sometimes to find out if you even got a picture, if it was exposed right. And digital makes that a lot easier, but it's not really a choice.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I don't prefer one format or the other. You got to get with the program, because nowadays you couldn't send a slide or a print to a magazine. They want a scan, so you have to send a scan.
Okay, this is interesting. Just to put it in perspective, I'm just going to name a few names of people that Bob has photographed. James Brown, Michael Jackson, Sonny and Cher, Little Richard, Marvin Gaye. Were you John Lennon's personal photographer?
Yeah, yeah.
You were John Lennon's personal, from the Beatles, personal photographer.
Yeah, when he wanted a picture, he would call me up. When his son Sean was born, he called me to come and take the baby pictures for the family. Things like that.
Did you ever have conversations like with John Lennon outside?
Oh, often, often. Yeah, I mean, a lot of times I would just stop by and watch TV with him, hang out.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't always about taking pictures. We actually developed a friendship. We liked each other.
What kind of things that we wouldn't know as the public that he was into, that John would talk about? I mean, was he into sports? Or?
Oh, well, actually, I was not really so much sports. He liked Monty Python and the English TV shows. But I was very impressed with his diet. He got into a macrobiotic diet where he was eating very healthy foods.
Mm-hmm.
And he really credited that with, you know, kind of keeping him healthy.
Wow. So a lot of people, where were you the day he was killed?
Actually, I was in the darkroom developing pictures I had taken 2 days earlier. I was supposed to go up there that night, and as usual, I was late.
Uh-huh.
But I was expecting to get there about an hour later when I got the phone call and found out that he had passed away.
Wow. You know, Bob Gruen is here. He has the new book, Rock Scene, Bob Gruen. One of the most celebrated photographers of our time. And if you're into any type of pop culture, music culture, I mean, you've seen a lot of changes in society, political and beyond. And if you ever seen the famous photo with John Lennon crossing his arms with a New York City shirt on, Bob took that shot.
Yep.
Yeah. And we were talking about one of many. The time John Lennon from the Beatles had made a comment that the Beatles were more popular than Jesus. In America, people went in an uproar. They start protesting the Beatles' music, and, you know, a lot of radio personalities start, you know, crushing their records on air, burning their paraphernalia, all that merchandise. And I remember John Lennon had a press conference and did not cop out to what he said. He said it was taken out of context, right? How did he feel about that?
Well, he felt that people misunderstood, you know, that he wasn't really knocking the religion or Jesus in general, but it was just kind of a fact. There were more people in the world nowadays than there were in the time of Jesus. And you know, Jesus didn't have TV. So, you know, the Beatles kind of got around the world a lot quicker than he did.
Wow.
So he wasn't really saying that, you know, comparing himself in any way to Jesus or, you know, any godly figure. He was just kind of relating to the media aspect of things. But he did, you know, explain it, and he fessed up to it. He didn't deny, you know, what he did.
Okay.
And he just said if he had offended anybody, he was really sorry about that, because he certainly didn't mean to offend anybody.
Well, you know, we I'm going to keep going through some names here, because, you know, today we were talking about the case for involuntary manslaughter with Conrad Murray. Kicked off when we were talking about the prosecution playing this audio of Michael Jackson, who was obviously intoxicated at the time he left a voice message before his untimely demise. And you had the opportunity to photograph the Jacksons and Michael. Mm. What was that, your first encounter?
I think Michael was about 16 then. It was in the mid-70s. Janet is in the picture. She looks about 8. Mm-hmm. They were all young and beginning.
Banging in.
Actually, it was before Michael had any of his face operations or anything. It's kind of the old look. And then the other picture of him live there is the new look. So
yeah, well, that actually wasn't the latest look, though.
No, it kept changing. It was kind of bizarre what he did to himself.
You ever talk to him, like, just, you know, like you did with John or anyone else?
Not a lot. I did one photo session. Actually, Diana Ross hired me to take pictures of her recording with Michael. And he was very sweet. Seemed quite innocent. I remember somebody told a dirty joke in the control room, and he didn't get it. You know,
What was the joke? Give me. I'm just curious. I want to see if I get it. you remember the joke?
No, I think it related to the famine in Africa at the time. It wasn't even funny, really.
Okay. You don't remember the joke? I love to hear a joke from the '70s, man. See, what was that like? The godfather of it all. If there would be no Michael Jackson if there was no James Brown. And I said that. I dare anybody refute me. All right. No Michael Jackson without James Brown. You filmed him. He was, you know, I heard stories. I got friends who work in the music business that said James was just a disciplinarian when it came to, you know, playing his music. If you went off beat a tenth of a count,
You got fined,
right?
Yeah, $50. Like, and the guys were only making like $50 at night or so. But if you were like a second late, change, because every couple of songs, the band would have to run off stage, change their suits, and come back. And you were a second late, you got fined. No matter what you did wrong, if you did anything wrong, there was a penalty.
Wow.
You know,
okay.
It wasn't like, you know, the rock and roll bands where they just kind of yell at each other. I mean, you paid for it.
You paid for it. All right. I'm going to go to the phone lines. Bob Gruen is here. Acclaimed photographer here. Critically acclaimed. We got Big Rich from Sacktown. What's going on, man?
Hey, man, I just wanted to tell you guys that the conversation was just totally excellent regarding Lynn and his comparison to Jesus Christ. And then when you got into the thing about Michael Jackson and James Brown, unrefutably, that is the truth, sir.
Thank you very much, man. I think Bob would agree, if I may say so. We got Jay from Long Beach. He wants some advice on new photographers. Jay, say hello to Bob.
Hey, good morning, both of you gentlemen, and hello to you as well. Sway, man, I go all the way back to listening to you late night on Power 106 out here in the West Coast.
Okay, Sway and Tech, Wake Up Show. Go to wakeupshow.com. We got a new website. All right, go ahead, man.
Okay. My question is, what is your advice to young photographers out there as far as getting exposure? It just seems like the market's saturated. Every other week I hear somebody, you know, that picked up a camera and, you know, I have X amount of prices for services, and that new camera person that just purchased the camera is you know, doing bargain basement prices, and it kind of messes up my game, essentially.
Well, that's always been that way. There's a lot of photographers that are very cutthroat. It's very difficult to make a living taking pictures, especially nowadays, because everybody thinks that anybody can do it. You don't even need a professional, which is not true, because professionals know about composition and timing and you know, how to get a picture out. But my advice to photographers is to take a lot of pictures, and then you're bound to get a couple of good ones. And then if you only show the good ones, people think you're good.
Oh, okay, so, that's
you know, a lot of people put a whole series of pictures up on their Facebook page or something like that. And instead of putting up 50 pictures, put up one or two good ones, and it'll really stand out that way.
That's some good advice. I'm gonna start doing that. Champ from Texas, what's your question, Champ?
Yeah, by way of Detroit. What's up, man? Oh. What up, Sway?
What up, man? How you feeling? Bob Gruen here is famous photographer, man. I want everybody to Google him if you don't know who he is and get his book.
I'm definitely familiar with his work because, you know, I love pictures. But as a fan of hip-hop, man, as somebody that's 35-plus, what have you seen in hip-hop that's been significant? And can you tell me some of your – have you taken a significant hip-hop photo that I may be unaware of, or something that may not have came out? That's my question.
Well, I saw hip-hop in the early days, in the early 80s. Mm-hmm. I used to go to the Roxy Theater and see Afro Bambaataa and, you know, Grandmaster Flash and one of those earlier groups that, that were really saying something back then. The kids spinning around on their heads and really doing breakdancing right there, challenging each other instead of to a fight, to a dance. Mm-hmm. You know, and I thought that was really cool that they were kind of challenging each other to who was the best dancer. Mm-hmm. And I've taken pictures of it, although personally I found going to some of the hip-hop shows was rather hostile towards a young white Jewish guy.
Yeah,
and it wasn't
with
really
an afro, might I add.
Yeah, but it wasn't really an environment that I felt comfortable. Mm-hmm. You know, several times I felt personally threatened, so I didn't make a point of going back too often.
Oh, it's changed now, man. They you know, you won't even get threatened. You just get shot, man. Don't worry about it. Shot. Nobody got that. Photographer,
photography
shot. Okay, come on.
Okay.
So you see, okay. Come on, man. Work with me. But come on, everybody.
Okay.
That was a joke from the 70s. not only that, you shot Deborah Harry. Blondie.
Debbie Harry and Iggy Pop.
Debbie Harry, who helped, you know, with Fab Five Freddie back in the day, got introduced to...
Oh, yeah, that's
to,
how I met Freddie back then.
Oh,
yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We're still friends today.
To that hipster scene, and he kind of introduced hip-hop to that hipster scene, and she had that song Rapture, right? Remember that? We got that?
He's in the video.
All right, cool. He's in the video?
Yeah.
Okay,
and
man.
And Debbie wrote the foreword for my book. We're
Did
still friends
really?
Today.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, wow. Yeah. She's still... Okay. Well, tell her we said hello. Bob, I know you got to go. I really appreciate this, man. You
got
to come back. I want to talk more stories, okay?
Okay,
and people could get this book where? How can they get the book?
Well, it's available in all the bookstores if you can find one. I'm doing a signing at the Marc Jacobs store this Friday night on Bleecker Street here in New York.
Okay.
It's on Amazon.com or BarnesandNoble.com.
It's okay. All right, man. Pleasure. I need you to sign my book. All right. You spell it S-W-A-Y.
Okay.
All right, Sway in the Morning, Shea 4-5, get in the game next.